Hello guys, I'm Philip Kimanzi. So today I'm gonna share with you on how to link CSS to HTML. So don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like and comment. So you need to watch every second of this video. It's so important to you. So let's start guys. So the first thing, you just come here and use your code compiler. On my side, I'll use Notepad. So you search for Notepad, you open it. So as you remember, last time we looked at our introduction to HTML and how to apply formatting in HTML. But today we want to look onto how you can link CSS to HTML. So you just write the symbol type of HTML. Doc type. HTML, then your class. In between HTML, write add. In between, write your clause with the add. In between add, you can write title. You can write linking CSS. CSS to HTML. Then you write title, your class. Okay, let's start guys. So after that, the link or not to link the CSS to HTML, you can put in between within HTML tags. But the best place you can put it is between. You can write the link anywhere in the program, but the recommended place you insert it in between end tags. So in between end tags, you can write in between end. You can write after end, you can write body. You close. After closing in between body, you can write H1. You can write adding one, which you said it goes up to H6. So you can write how to link CSS and HTML. How to link CSS with HTML. Then you can write H1, you close. After you close, you can continue and write paragraph P. Then you can write CSS is used CSS is used to apply styles in HTML program. Where else you can write document. You can change the font size the fold size for the family, for the family, for the weight, among many other, among many other styles, among many other styles, by just incorporating CSS in a HTML document. In order to make this change, in order to make these changes to your, in order to make these changes to your HTML document, you will have to write this code in your HTML program. Then you can close the paragraph. So, guys, so that we are just writing a simple HTML program. So we are saying that HTML or CSS is used to apply. It's used to apply styles in HTML document. You can change the font size, font family, font background color. You can see insert images. You can make changes to the images. You can set many styles you can by linking CSS to HTML document. So there's a code that you need to insert in between editors. So after inserting that code, you'll now create a new file. So let's start. So this is a simple HTML document. So you can save it. Kenya.html. So you have saved your work. So let's see how it looks. So just come here and you search for it. So you just open it. Let's see how it looks like. Okay. Case. Okay, sorry, we have not closed there. So just go there and search for your document. Is here Kenya, you open it. Okay, so you can see the title, linking CSS to HTML. We have add-in, you can look here, yeah, how to link CSS and HTML. So yeah, then you can see your paragraph here. Now, we want to make changes to this HTML document now by linking it to CSS. So just minimize, then you come here and say file, create new. You create new, then in between there you can write, let's say you want to make changes to add-in, you can write add-in, you can write add-in, then you put this type of brackets. In between there you can write, you can write, let's say color, let's say green, or else let's say tomato. So that is, so then you save your work, you control S to save your work, then in between there you can write styles, style dot CSS, styles dot CSS. You can write style.css. You can see you have saved your work as styles.css. So what you do, you come to your program, your other program. So you can come here, then it was called this one. So it's called Kenya. So just come here, then you right click, then you open, you open with notepad to edit your work is here. So then you maximize. After maximizing, now you just come here in between editors, then you can link it, so you just write link rel, styles, style sheet. Then you can write href equals, can write style dot CSS as you have saved it there. So you can have another name here, but should be dot CSS, file type is CSS. So write type equals to test stroke CSS stroke, then you can put that sign. So okay, sorry, in between here you can close with the speech marks there. So you can save your work, so then you come here, your work here, then you refresh, you see the color has changed to tomato, so you just go there and search your file there, styles, it's called styles, I think it is this one. So just open it to continue editing, you can maximize, then you can continue adding, you can write Fold size, fold size. You can write 20px, 20, or you can write 30px, then you write semicolon. You can write fold family, then you can write fold family, you can write fedana, then you semicolon, then you save your work. After saving your work, you just come here, then you refresh. You can see it has appeared in big numbers. It is it has changed the font family. Now it's in fedana. So just continue editing your work. You just continue editing your work. So just come here. Okay, let's say you want to make other changes to paragraph. You just write p, you put those type of brackets, then in between those brackets you can make any change that you want to appear in your program. So you can write color, you can change it to, you can write it into green, you can write it into green, then your semicolon. Then you can write something like for the weight, you can write for the weight, you can write for the weight, you can write bold, and write bold. Then you put your semicolon. Okay, you can write something like, you can put many things as you wish. So you can write say test align. You can write at right where you want your test to be positioned in your document. So just come here, then you refresh. You see, the color has changed to green. The test is in bold, and the test has been positioned in the right side. So you can make many changes as you wish. You can write many styles. So as I shared last time, I shared how to apply formatting and several types of formatting. So you can look onto those formatting styles and many more. So you just continue. You can write body. You wish to make the changes to the body. So you can insert many things. That make changes to the body. You can write background color. Background color. You can write gray. Then you put your sign. Then you can write something like, let's see how it appears. Change the background color, then you refresh. Okay. Background color. So there's a problem here. So this programming is case sensitive. So if you make a wrong mistake in spelling, it won't produce anything. So you can see the problem was you and inserted G there instead of D, and now you can see how it has started. So you just come here, you refresh, and you can see the background color has changed to gray. So you may continue. Right. Let's say you want to insert background image. So first thing, what you do, you just make sure you create a folder, you create a folder. Then after creating the folder, you can write it LangTech. Okay, you can write it as styles. Then all your work, you just transfer it to there. The style, you just move it to that styles. You can also look for the other one, Kenya. Look for the other one, Kenya. Just to transfer it. Just transfer it there. Then you look for the image now you want to insert. So I add an image here. So let's say you want to insert this image. So you just move it here. Just move it there. So you can open it. You see, you have the your HTML program, your CSS style. Then you have the image here. Now, if you want to insert that image, just come here in your style. Then you can maximize the. Then here you write background image. You can write URL. Then you can write scenery dot gpg. Then you can close. Then in there you can write those, and you close there. Then you save your work. Then you come here and refresh. Okay, let's see. So you just go to your work. HTML document. See, the image has been inserted. But as the way you are seeing it, the image is so divided, is subdivided to many, images, small images. So what you can do, you can continue and write in your program. Just come here and continue writing. You can hand it out the way you want your image to look like. You can continue and write background size the way you want it to be. Background size. Then you can write cover. Then you can write background position, where you want it to be located. Background position, where you want it to be located. You can write center. It should be at the center. You can write something called box sizing. Then you can write border box, then semicolon. Then you save your work. You just come here and you refresh. You see, now it has appeared as a one image covering the whole page. So now it looks nice. You see, so it looks nice. So what you do, just continue, write. You can insert as many things as you want in the body part. You can insert something you called border. You can write border. The line that should appear around the text, around the body part. So you can write it as, border. You can write, let's say, 5 px px solid black. So then you save your work. Just come here and refresh your site. See, you have a line, you have a border surrounding your work, around. So you can continue and write. You can make changes to the heading, and then you can write border. Then you can write 4px solid. Then you can write dashed. Then you can write, let's say, purple. You can write semicolon. Then you save your work. You just come here and you refresh. You see, now the heading how to link CSS and HTML, it has appeared dashed. It has appeared with a border dashed around. So that's how you insert a border around a text in your site. You see, so you can make many changes as you can. You can make changes to the whole HTML document by just creating another file for styles, then you save it .css. You can make many changes as you can to the heading. If you have a footer, you can insert it. If you have a paragraph, a big paragraph, you can insert it. You can make many changes. If you have another heading, you just write where you want to apply those changes, where you want to format, where you want to make changes in that document, and the way you want it to appear. So, in my last video, I shared more about formatting and many styles. So you can follow me on my channel, subscribe, keep updated. I'll be sharing more videos and the tutorials especially for the beginners and those who wish to start web development. I'll help you to learn through my videos and my site. Below in my video, there's a site. If you don't understand in the video, I've shared a link for our website that will direct you to where I've written my work in PDF form. So you can just use it and send instead of following on my videos, you can read it also in my website. So below my video in the description part, you'll find a link. Follow on that link and you'll find useful information for you. If you like my video, you can subscribe, comment and like. Thank you guys for watching.
Mm-hmm.